I recently discovered the white noise machine that I swear by isn't white noise at all. It's pink noise. That sent me down a rabbit hole of research, and today I'm going to share my findings with you on what's better for sleep, pink noise or white noise. So what actually is the difference between pink noise and white noise? So white noise is all audible frequencies at the same intensity, whereas pink noise is all audible frequencies, but the intensity drops off as the frequency increases. And if you're anything like me and you're wondering why it's named different colors of noise, it's named for the visible light that is produced when you use the same power spectrum. Some common uses for either pink noise or white noise are to drown out annoying sounds, whether that's conversations or annoying noises. It's also used for relaxation. So now that we know what the difference is, why does it matter? Different colors of noise are perceived differently. Pink noise is commonly considered to be less abrasive, and it's closer to leaves rustling or the sound of rain, whereas white noise is closer to static. If you've ever turned your TV to a channel that doesn't exist, the sound that plays, that's white noise. At least in my experience, I find white noise to be very subtly grating. It's just a tiny bit annoying and I can't really tune it out, whereas pink noise I find to be really relaxing and definitely is my preference. So how do these different colors of noises affect sleep? So pink noise or white noise, the best use is to mask out sounds. So it's basically just having a background noise to drown out other sounds that happen while you're asleep so that you won't wake up in the middle of the night, whether that's, you know, somebody flushing the toilet in your house or the neighbor's dog barking. It just provides a blanket of sound so that you can stay asleep. I did find a really interesting study that looked at pink noise and its effect on brainwaves while sleeping, and it found that it decreased brainwave complexity, which resulted in higher sleep quality. So basically what that means is that it's an easy hack to get deeper sleep. Now, as far as pink noise versus white noise and what the best is for sleep, sadly, there's no study that directly compares the two specifically for sleep. So what we have to do is we have to take other studies that compare pink noise and white noise and take the results for that study and extrapolate that to what we know about sleep. I did find another study that looked at the comparison between pink noise, white noise, and no noise, and it found that out of all of them, pink noise reduced brainwave complexity. Now, when we compare that to the study that I had just talked about, we do know that reduced brainwave complexity allows you to sleep better. Now, as far as why this might be, I did find a paper that theorized that the reason that pink noise is so beneficial on sleep is because pink noise is commonly found in nature. Now, if you've seen other videos of mine before, you know that I love evolutionary biology and looking at things through a lens of what humans are adapted for. And if you look at it through that lens, it does make sense that, you know, when we were back in hunter-gatherer tribes, let's say, that we would commonly be hearing these kinds of sounds, therefore they would be beneficial for our sleep. Now, that's not to say that white noise isn't beneficial for sleep. In fact, I would say it's probably more common to find studies looking at white noise in sleep versus pink noise. I found one study that looked at coronary care patients that had been hospitalized. It found that white noise assisted with noise masking and time to fall asleep and maintaining sleep. But that's enough to say that all white noise is beneficial. I found another study that looked at white noise that was being played at 93 decibels. To give you a frame of reference, 90 decibels is how loud a lawnmower is, so that's pretty loud. And for that study, they found decreased REM sleep. The other stages of sleep were unaffected. There was yet another study that looked at white noise for college students that had roommates. For that study, they found that white noise assisted with time to fall asleep and decreased number of awakenings at night. I would say if we were to summarize the available studies looking at pink noise and white noise, the commonality for the white noise studies is that they're more focused on time to fall asleep and maintaining sleep and like noise masking, whereas the pink noise studies are more focused on brain activity and having deeper sleep. So then what's better, pink noise or white noise? I would say overall, some level of noise masking is better than no noise masking. And for pink noise or white noise being better, it really depends what your ultimate goal is. If your goal is more focused on just staying asleep, I think it really doesn't matter pink noise versus white noise. Whereas if you're more focused on the quality of sleep, I would recommend starting with pink noise. I do think though that personal preference does play a little bit into this, and you're going to need to find what you specifically find the most relaxing, because that obviously is going to be more beneficial for you than something that doesn't help as much and you find annoying.
If you're trying to figure out what you find the most relaxing, I would either download an app or just start here on YouTube and type like white noise sleep, pink noise sleep, and just see what really resonates with you. Also, in the next couple of days, I am going to be posting a video on pink noise for sleep, so check that out if you're interested at all. If you're looking for a recommendation for a sound machine, I wholeheartedly endorse the Yoga Sleep Dome Classic Sound Machine. It also used to be called the Dome Marpac Sound Machine. It is by far my favorite noise machine. This one does do pink noise, and it is so customizable. I love that the sound is fan-based versus electronic, and you can adjust the loudness, you can adjust the pitch to whatever really resonates with you. If you're gonna buy it, do not buy it on Amazon. Amazon, he has a huge problem with fakes for this machine. I got mine from Bed Bath & Beyond. It has free shipping. You can use a coupon on it, but I would not get it from Amazon. I can personally attest that I really do get better quality sleep and I'm more well-rested when I use this machine. So I definitely think that it's worth checking out. And I totally do notice if I forget to use it on any given night. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up so I know you enjoyed it. Sweet dreams!